My name is Sori Jang, and I'm a graduate student working in Daniel Colon-Ramos' lab at Yale. It's only been 2 years since I got here. I went to an undergrad at the University of Chicago, and I grew up half the time in Korea and half the time in Ohio. I'm currently working on how hypoxia, or lack of oxygen, affects how neurons communicate or how synaptic vesicles are affected by the lack of oxygen. I was born here, but I went back to Korea because of my dad's occupation. And I came back for elementary school for 3 years, and I went back, and I came back for high school. So there were a lot of transitioning back and forth, and I'm actually really grateful that I was able to come back in high school. So in Korea, like when you hit freshman year of high school, you have to decide whether you want to go into like math, engineering, science field, or humanities side. So you decide, and then the second year, you start the track. And after my freshman year in high school in Korea, I was like, I don't think science, math, those things are for me. Actually, very small percentage of girls go into that field. I think that was partly one of the reasons why I didn't think I was suitable for science. I mean, I also loved growing up in Korea. I learned valuable things in Korea, just as I learned valuable things here. But I think coming back to the States really gave me a broader field of where I can go. Because in Korea, I limited myself to, okay, I'll go into humanities side. Here, when I came back, like I felt really strongly about chemistry, and I really liked it. I just enjoyed it. I thought it was really fascinating that everything was composed of these little tiny, tiny molecules called atoms, and it's just fascinating how everything is composed of that. And like some people really like something broad, like universe. Like they look at the stars and see, oh, look at all like the galaxy. Like we're just a little thing in this huge space. But for me, I think I always like the opposite, where I was fascinated by these tiny little things that actually composed of so many things. So I really liked about that, about chemistry. But I would have missed out an opportunity to take classes like that in Korea. Initially, my dad didn't want me to apply for graduate school because the concept of a scientist is kind of foreign to them, especially for a girl. And at first, when I was telling them that I wanted to do biology, they wanted me to gear towards medicine, as a lot of parents do. But I just could never imagine myself as a doctor. I really enjoy the creativity. So one thing I really like about research in general is that you're constantly thinking, and you're constantly, whether it's just little things, whether you're devising experiments to do, the little steps to build the larger picture, you have to think constantly to get to build that picture. You have to constantly think about what's the right little steps to take. And also interpreting your data to build the right picture. So all of these things require constant thinking, and it's sometimes challenging, but I think it's a very rewarding experience, and that's what I think why I really enjoy being in science, like being a researcher.
Thank you.